here called The Legend of Seaside. It may be a poem, actually, but... Seaside. Some people say it's rumor, outright lies, but I'll tell you the truth as seen from my eyes. So if you have the patience and a listening ear, I'll recount the tale of eight friends dear. All these ladies are grown, but you do need to know they were friends back when their desks stood in rows, in classrooms, in schools that were filled with glee, from Longfellow, Washington, and Newton P. With pigtails and can-cans, lunchboxes and bows, they skipped to their schools, so the story goes. And then on to Southern, they were rebels indeed. Slides to sock hops, the eight had no need to ever consider their bond would not hold, not boyfriends, not high school, nor the red devil, I'm told, could shake the love that acted as glue and held them together all the way through till college and adulthood called all eight to campuses, careers, to babies, but wait, the story wouldn't end, their bond would not break, it just faded still there, needing something to shake up the memories and pull them back at long last to the hilarious laughter and the love of the past. That's where Seaside stepped in and caused a reaction that magically drew them to magnetic attraction. You see, one of the girls knew a deal when she saw it, a beachside structure, a castle, and she bought it. Being of sound mind and a generous heart, she soon brought them together, never to part. The tale could now end, but alas, I fear there are more adventures you may need to hear. There's dancing and dining and laughing away. There's climbing spiral stairs with pink drinks on a tray. Dressed in their finest, getting ready to light on unsuspecting restaurants for the joy-filled nights. Of course, the story would be told as unfair if I failed to mention this thing with their hair. No talking, no acting, turn once again, boofing and smoothing to a gorgeous end. A handsome special friend filled with air who once came flying down the stairs. The mini mall and dip out dote, buying enough wine to sink a boat. Climbing the steps singing O-E-O. Climbing the steps, singing O-E-O. Crying because they were laughing so. Celebrating together their lives of years 60. Thinking they all looked no older than 50. The blue umbrellas, the white sandy shore. Cruising 30A and pearls galore. Wearing their jewels, feeling oh so sassy, making a stop, of course, perspicacity. Husbands and foes, not totally forgotten, one even bush giggles and tells us the lure of this place is more than satisfaction. It's the love that lives at magnetic attraction. The place where there were ants and fears are a sign, all forever blessed in the arms of Seaside. Written with love and unspeakable gratitude by Kathy Posey Oldham.
Thanks, you guys, for sharing.